Hello, good morning friends. Today I'll discuss about a problem related to slope deflection method, generally a frame structure. In my previous lecture I discussed about a beam related to slope deflection, and now in this lecture I will discuss about a frame. How to solve a frame by using the slope deflection method. So I have taken here a frame, that is the A, B, C, D and E. Okay, it is perfectly rigid, that means no sway will take place due to the applied force. Okay, so for portion AB its inertia is 3i, and portion BC and CD inertia is the 2i. Okay, it's 2i, and for the portion BE inertia is I. So in case we know that slope deflection formula is what the whether is the MAB, just for this portion MAB equals to FEM AB plus 2EI, sorry, it will be 3EI by L into theta A minus del by L. So here in this case del is zero because it is a non-sway frame, it is perfectly rigid. Okay, no displacement will take place here, that's why the value of the theta will delta will be zero. Okay, so mind it. So I am discussing here for a non-sway frame. Okay, so in case of the sway frame, if it is sway frame, so we have to take the value of delta, and delta will be unknown. Okay, in case of a sway frame, and in case of non sway frame, so delta value will be zero for breast structure. Okay, so now first of all I will discuss about this portion for span AB. See here, span AB is end span. Okay, span AB is the end span, and we know that for end span MAB, that is the hinges, so MAB will be zero. I have discussed about it in my previous lecture. Okay, so that's why I am not discussing here about this MAB, how it will be zero. So you know that MAB will be zero, so for span AB MAB will be zero. And now we have to discuss about the MBA. So MBA equals to FEMBA plus 3EI1, and we know that here is the I is the 3i, 3 times of I. So I am writing here, it is the 3i1 into theta b minus del by l. Okay, here i1 equals to 3i. Okay, so here FEMAB fixed end moment for FEMBA will be zero because no loading is acting here. We know that the fixed end moment is a function of what, load. So as this span is without any loading, that's why the fixed end moment FEMBA will be zero. Okay, so we are from this we are taking this equation MBA equals to 9EI by L to theta B. Okay, this is number one equation. Okay, as I1 equals to 3I, that's why it will be 9EI. Okay, 9EI by L to theta B. Okay, now for span B, now notice here this span is also having no loading, that means here also the value of the FEM fixed end moment B2A or and E2B will also be zero. Okay, so here for span B MEB from E2B MEB will be FEMEB plus 2EI by L plus 2 theta E plus theta B minus 3 delta by L. Here as it is non-sway frame, that's why the value of the delta will be zero, no deflection is taking place here. And now theta L is fixed end, so theta at the fixed end theta value will be zero, that's why it is also zero. And here FEMAB, as this span is span having no load, okay, this one is carrying no load, that's why the value of fixed end moment will be zero. So it will be, so we are taking FEMAB as zero, so the equation will be MEB equals to 2EI by L, okay, into theta B. Now, here from BE, MBE will be FEMBE plus 2EI by L into 2 theta B, 2 times of the theta B plus theta E minus 3. Here similarly, theta E value will be 0, okay, as this end is fixed, okay. This end is fixed, and FEMBE, it will FEMBE will also be 0 because this is span having no loading, okay. So from this we will get this equation MB equals to T2EI by L into 2 theta B, okay. Now for span BC, now we have to concentrate here, we have to, it is the most important part of this frame, okay. So now notice here, this is CD portion is things, and this portion say having loading of 20 kilonewton per meter and its length is 2.5 meter. So what we will do, we have to omit this overhang portion by taking the moment of the loading, taking the moment producing for this loading of 2.5 meter length. So now here I will show how to omit this loading. So this is the BC span, and its length is 5 meter, and its length is 2.5 meter. So the moment created by this loading will be, total load is will be how much, 2.5 into 20, and we know that for the uniform distributed load, moment will be WL square by 2. So that why the moment will be W20 into 2.5 square by 2. So this amount of moment will be created here. Okay, created here for this loading. Okay. So, and we know this moment, as this moment is clockwise. So here, this moment is clockwise. So half of the moment will be carry over here. That means this. That means at the moment of this portion will be at this point will be how much, half into 20 into 2.5 square by 2, half moment will be carry over here. So net moment at this point B, that is the FEMBC will be how much, W minus WL square by 8 plus half, it is in case of the uniformly distributed in this type of the loading. So moment at this point will be as a anti-clockwise moment, WL by WL square by 8, as it is anti-clockwise moment. So net moment will be this moment plus this moment, this moment transferred from this, okay, this so the moment will be addition of the minus WL square by 8 plus half into 20 into 2.5 square by 2. So from this we will get MBC value. MBC value will be in this way, okay. Now and the value for the MCB will also be 0, okay. The value of the MCB will be 0. So from this equation, that means 1, 2, 3, and 4, from this 4 equation we have to prepare an equilibrium equation. So now notice here A, B, C and E, okay. So this point, for this point we have to prepare an equilibrium equation. So from moment from B to A, that means MBA, moment from B to C MBC, and moment from B to E MBE will be 0, okay, MB will be 0. So so from this equation we will find the value of theta B, and we have to put the value of theta B in this equation MEB MBE. So if we find the value of the theta B, so we can easily put the value in this equation, and we will get the final moment, okay. So this is all about the slope deflection method for a non-sway frame. In my next lecture, I will discuss about the slope deflection method in case of a sway frame. Okay, thank you.